In this example, we have a balloon that's being filled with air at a rate of 9 cubic inches every minute. Now that's going to make the radius get larger. The radius is going to increase because we're pumping air into it. Here's the question that they ask. They say, how fast is the radius changing when the radius is 5 inches and 12 inches? Now, before we begin, let's make an educated guess. It's always good just to kind of think about these before we jump into it. All right, as I'm filling this thing up with air, what I would probably expect to happen is probably initially that radius is going to increase pretty fast because the balloon's still pretty small. But, you know, if you had a balloon as wide as your arms and, you know, you stretched out your arms and you had a balloon with a massive radius, pumping 9 cubic inches in every minute probably isn't going to make a super big difference in that radius. So just an educated guess, probably the answer for part A will be larger. It'll be a faster rate of change than the answer in part B when the radius is 12 inches versus 5 inches. Okay, so now let's zoom out. Let's think, how do we solve all related rates problems? Because that's what this is. Here's your instructions. Here's your steps to solve them. First of all, you need a picture. So if you don't have one, draw one so you can kind of visualize what's going on and how the variables are related to one another. Step number two, find some sort of equation that relates all of those variables. So let's start with that. So I read the problem. I see a balloon being filled with air. That sounds to me just like volume, you know, because we have cubic inches is volume. And so we've got a volume formula, and the volume depends on what? Well, the volume depends on the radius of the balloon, like how big is the balloon? And so right off the bat, I think we're going to use the formula V equals 4/3 pi r cubed, and that's the volume of a sphere. Now, this is one of those things, it really depends on who you had as a teacher or instructor in a previous class. We assume that students know that formula. So if you didn't know that, you've got to be in trouble. There are a few formulas like that. The volume of a box is length times width times height. We assume people know that. The area of a circle is pi r square. The circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. The area of a triangle is 1/2 base times height. Pythagorean theorem, we assume people know. There's a list of probably 10 or 12 just different basic geometry formulas and algebra formulas that we just kind of assume that students know. One of them is the volume of the sphere. So if you didn't know that, put it on a flashcard or something and commit this one to memory. Okay, so now that's our static still equation. That's an algebra equation relating all the information that relates the volume of a balloon to the radius of the balloon that's not being blown up. So if you give me a radius of 10 inches, I could figure out what the volume is. Or if you said the volume is 400 cubic inches, we could figure out what the equivalent radius is. But there's no movement, nobody's blowing up a balloon. So now, what do we do next? How do we see the motion? How do you see the rates of change? Well, we're going to take derivatives. That's where we get our see the motion from, the rate of change, by differentiating with respect to time. Now that's going to require some implicit differentiation because we're going to be differentiating the V and the expression with R, not with respect to V or R, but with time, with T. And so that's going to require implicit differentiation. All right, lastly, we're going to plug in all the information that they tell us and solve for the quantity that they don't tell us. So let's give that a shot. So derivatives come first. Here we go. Derivative of volume with respect to time. That'd be dv dt, change in volume over change in time. Derivative of 4/3 pi r cubed. The 4/3 and pi are constants, and the 3 could come down and multiply, because r is a variable, to the 4/3, and you get just a 4 pi r squared, power rule. And then because this is an r, not a t, we'd follow that with, you could kind of think of it as the chain rule, the derivative of r with respect to t. Okay, now let's see, what do they tell us? Well, they say the balloon is being filled with air at a rate, hint, hint, rate of 9 cubic inches per minute. So something's 9. So look at this formula. Who's 9? Who's 9? Well, it's this guy. It's the change in volume over change in time. 9 cubic inches every minute equals 4 pi blank squared. All right, now what's the radius? Well, it says, how fast is the radius changing when the radius is? Okay, so we'll do part A first. Let's make R 5 inches. So this is actually part A times dr dt. Okay, and then matter of fact, while we're at it, let's just go ahead and copy that same thing down for part B. 9 equals 4 pi blank squared dr dt. The only difference for part B was that we wanted to consider the radius when it's 12 inches, not 5 inches. Okay. And then in both of these, we're going to solve for the missing quantity, namely dr dt. Now, let's just not do that just process of elimination. Let's think about why. Why are we looking for that? Well, what'd they ask us? They said, how fast, hint, hint, that's a key word for rate, how fast is the radius changing? So change in radius over change in time. Yeah, that sounds like dr dt. Sounds great. All right, so final answer, dr dt. Dr dt would be, all right, we're gonna need a little calculator help here. Okay, so let's see here. It'd be 9 divided by the quantity 4 pi times 5 squared. Be careful with your parentheses. Okay, so we got 0.0286, 0.0286. And compared to 9 divided by quantity 4 times pi times 12 squared. So I'll snag this real quick. Okay, so here we go. 0.0286. 0.0286. That's inches per minute. And the other is, as we guessed, as we anticipated, much smaller. 0.00497 inches per minute. Okay, so it looks like this balloon isn't being blown up very fast. That's why we got such small answers here. But yeah, the radius is increasing faster when the radius is smaller when we tested it, and slower when we checked it for the larger radius. So all this intuitively makes pretty good sense. So to recap real quickly, we drew a picture. You find an equation that relates all your quantities, but there's no motion there. You see no rates of change. So you differentiate with respect to time to bring out the rates. You plug in everything that they tell you. Sometimes you have to do a little algebra to find a few of the quantities, but everything that you need is there except for the guy that you're solving for. So plug in all the information they give you and solve for the desired quantity.